that you think is your good picture, and the other one which is your worst picture. Because maybe the good one you may not like at the end of the day, and that your worst one might be holding so much wonder. Maybe if something's presented to us, just question it, or look beneath it, or look behind it, or rather than a lovely flower, you might just see the stem and don't photograph the flower that's there. Ignore the flower. You know what I mean? Or
ignore the focus.
Pardon?
Ignore the focus.
Yeah, and it sounds easy, but it's quite hard to do. How long were you photographing for then? 20 minutes? So I think that's a great example of time. I mean, already I've seen some really good pictures, and I think sometimes we put so much emphasis on time. Like, you could spend 3 years, and I have the making or long photographic bodies of work, and it can be a complete disaster, or you can spend 20 minutes and you can make a masterpiece for this. I saw this picture outside for the first time just on the back of the screen, and I think it's a really great way of thinking for me, because it's exactly what we were talking about earlier as well, just sort of not looking at everything on face value or how things are presented to us, but photography is so good at looking underneath and questioning and looking at the layers of life.